In this video, we're continuing on in the multi-step special right triangles worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free geometry worksheet. Now, in the last video, we dealt with 45, 45, 90 triangles, and in this video, we're going to be dealing also with 30, 60, 90. So for 30, 60, 90, remember the ratio is 1 to the square root of 3 to 2. So this will be y square root of 3y and 2 times y, or whatever variable you prefer. So looking at number 7, across from 60 will be the square root of 3 times y, and across from 30 in this first triangle will be 1y or y. So that means 9 is equal to 2y. So dividing by 2, we'll get that 9 halves is equal to y. I'm not concerned with this y over here, however, I'm concerned with this hypotenuse where we have the square root of 3y, since that will help me solve for x. So this side, square root of 3y, is equal to 9 halves times the square root of 3, which is 9 times the square root of 3 over 2. That is this side length, which if we set up a ratio across from 30 is 1, so that will be x. So across from 60, we'll have the square root of 3x. That means that the square root of 3y, which is 9 times the square root of 3 over 2, that's going to be equal to 2 times x, since it's the leg of one triangle and the hypotenuse of another triangle. So 9 times the square root of 3 over 2 is equal to 2x. So if I divide by 2, that's the same as multiplying by 1 over 2, so I'll have 9 times the square root of 3 over 4 equal to x. So x is 9 times the square root of 3 over 4 in number 7. So again, I solved for y in order to solve for this leg length, which was the hypotenuse, so I used the hypotenuse then to solve for x. And number 8, again I'll set up my ratio in this triangle on the left. So 5 represents 2y, so across from 30 degrees we will have y, and across from 60 we'll have the square root of 3 times y. However, we're not concerned with the square root of 3 times y, we're concerned with this side y, since it's also a part of our other triangle. So when I divide by 2, I'll get that 5 halves is equal to y. So this y is equal to 5 halves. Now if this side length is 5 halves, it is across from 60 degrees in my other triangle. So this y of 5 halves is across from 60 degrees. So the ratio is going to be the square root of 3 times some variable we're going to use a. In the last problem, we were able to use x since x was across from 30. However, across from 30 is an empty side we'll call a. So a to the square root of 3 times a, which is our y value, to what is across from 90 degrees, x, which will be 2a. So now we're going to solve for a and then plug that value of a in to solve for x. So we have 5 halves equal to the square root of 3 times a. We'll divide both sides by the square root of 3. Dividing by the square root of 3 is the same as multiplying by 1 over the square root of 3. So our a value is going to equal 5, which is our numerator value since 1 times 5 is 5, over 2 times the square root of 3. However, I don't want a radical in my denominator, so I'm going to multiply by the square root of 3 over the square root of 3. So a is going to be equal to 5 times the square root of 3 all over 2 times 3, which is 6. Now I'm going to plug that a value in for my equation with x. So if x is equal to 2 times a, then x is going to be equal to 2 times 5 times the square root of 3 over 6. So that's going to be x equal to 10 square root of 3 over 6, which we can simplify since 2 goes into 10 5 times, and 2 goes into 6 3 times. We'll get 5 times the square root of 3 over 3 as our solution in number 8. So x is 5 times the square root of 3 over 3. And number 9, our x is across from 60 degrees. So x is going to be the square root of 3 times some variable. Let's use a again. So the square root of 3 times a is x. So that means that across from 30 degrees is going to be 1 times a, or simply a. So now we're going to use this triangle on the left in order to solve for A, which will then plug in for X. Now, notice in that triangle on the left, it's also a 30, 60, 90, and across from 30 will be 1, across from 60 is the square root of 3. So let's use a new variable. A is going to be the square root of 3 times y. And across from 30 is 1 times y, so 10 is equal to y. And then across from 90, we would have 2y. However, we don't need that hypotenuse length, so we're just going to look at this side, A. So if A is equal to the square root of 3 times y, then A is going to be equal to the square root of 3 times 10. So A we can write as 10 times the square root of 3. Now, since x is equal to the square root of 3 times A, we'll plug A in. So the square root of 3 times 10 times the square root of 3, which we'll write as x equal to 10 times the square root of 3 times the square root of 3. So x is going to equal 10 times 3, which will give us 30. So x is 30 in number 9. In number 10, we have a 90 degree angle here, so that means that x is our hypotenuse. So x is going to equal 2 times some variable, let's call that variable a. Here is our 30 degree angle in that special right triangle, so across from 30, this length that we need to know is a. So let's solve for a and then plug that in for x. 60 degrees is directly across from a. So that side that's across from that angle of 60 degrees is equal to the square root of 3 times, let's use y. And directly across from 90 represents 2y. So if 8 equals 2y, I'll divide by 2 to get that 4 is equal to y. Now I can plug y in to solve for a. Since a is equal to the square root of 3 times y, a is going to be equal to 4 times the square root of 3. And now I can plug a in to solve for x. X equals 2 times a, so x is equal to 2 times 4 times the square root of 3. 2 times 4 is 8, and 8 times the square root of 3 is equal to x. That's our answer in number 10, 8 square root of 3. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 11. If you haven't already, click that subscribe button and like this video. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and let me know that you're finding these videos helpful. They also encourage me to make more videos for you. So the more subscriptions, hopefully the more videos. Now, across from 60 is x, so we're going to set x as the square root of 3 times, we'll use a again. We need this side length, which happens to be the hypotenuse, in order to solve for x. So we'll make that, since it's across from 90 degrees, to a. So looking at our top special right triangle, 30 degrees is this top angle, and across from 30 degrees represents 1. So 2a can be our variable y, and across from 60 degrees we have the square root of 3 times y. So 5 equals the square root of 3 times y. I'll plug 2a in, so I'll have 5 times the square root of 3 times 2a. So what I'll do is divide by 2 times the square root of 3. In doing that, my 2 and my square root of 3 will cancel out. So I'll get that 5 over 2 times the square root of 3 is equal to a. However, I don't want a radical in my denominator, so I'll multiply by the square root of 3 over the square root of 3. That'll give me 5 times the square root of 3 all over 2 times the square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is 2 times 3, which is 6. So 5 sixths times the square root of 3, or 5 times the square root of 3 over 6 is equal to a. Knowing a, I can plug that in to solve for x. X is equal to the square root of 3 times a. So x equals the square root of 3 times 5 times the square root of 3 over 2. So x equals 5 times the square root of 3 times the square root of 3, which is 5 times 3, over 2. X equals 15, since 5 times 3 is 15, all over 2. So 15 halves is my solution in number 11. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 12 through 16. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.